All right, everyone, Cody here. So today I'm going to be working on my ball mill. I built this thing back in high school and it did work. I crushed lots of rock samples and I made some aluminum powder with this thing. But really, it had some major flaws. Like, for instance, this motor just would run too fast. And so I had to put the belt on the shaft of it and let it slip a little bit in order to get the drum to rotate at the right speed. That didn't work so well. You know, if I let it run for more than a few hours, it'd burn the belt off. So today I'm going to be doing some modifications to get this thing to actually work properly. I think the main thing I'm going to be doing is gearing it down. Use some pulleys and smaller pulleys. And basically transform the rotations of this motor into something that's slower and more powerful. So I just got done cutting off the original bearings. They really couldn't handle the impact. And so, I've been marking it out to put on this bigger bearing here. This is actually a wheel bearing from a car, so should be much better. So I'm using this disc here as what I'm going to be running the belt on. And then here's the bearing. Now I left a hole here. I did that intentionally. This way I can blow air through the whole apparatus. See, if you look at this on the other side, it doesn't get into the bearing at all. So I could blow air through it and blow dust out of there and turn this thing into a continuous feed. All right, there it is. That's the drum. I got the bearings and the lid and everything all bolted together. Look at this. It turns. It actually turns pretty easy. Nice. These end caps are gonna have to be modified now. There we go. The bearing end caps are on. I think that'll work just fine. You know, probably not keep that forever, but it's good for now. Let's go ahead and weld in a cross brace here. Cross brace in. Now I gotta work on these reducer pulleys. All right, so there we go. That's rotating at about the right speed even. I just got some pieces of twine on here temporarily because I'm still working on these pulleys. You see, it's got a bit of a wobble there that I need to fix. See, I got some ore here that I've crushed up in my jaw crusher. But really, this is way too coarse in order to leach anything from it. It needs to be a very fine powder, like talcum powder, and a ball mill is exactly what it needs to do. So I think this would be a good little test. So I went ahead and put some more crushing media in there. You can see the ore. I kind of ruined my gasket, so I made this piece out of cardboard, which will only work once, but we'll keep the dust from getting out. Go ahead and stuff a rag in here for now. I don't have a blower system set up yet. And it runs! It's incredibly loud, but look at this thing. Isn't that cool? It's going the perfect speed. So I let it run for about an hour. Got the lid unbolted. Let's go ahead and have a look in there. Here we are. It certainly looks like powder in here. Let's get some of this stuff. See how that looks. Yeah, that is very fine. Look at that. Excellent. I don't see anything wrong with that. It works. Okay. Eventually I want to take that ball mill and make it so I can have a continuous feed process like I've mentioned. And I think the next video that I make, including the ball mill, I'll be making some aluminum powder. So be sure to stay tuned for that. I'll see you next time.